Hey everyone, welcome back to Tech Talk. I'm Julia Beauchamp and I am here with CSO's Jay Empurup. We are going to be talking about Hacker Summer Camp that is next week in Las Vegas, so stick around. All right, JM, thank you so much for calling in from us. When are you leaving for Hacker Summer Camp?
I'm off on Monday morning, which
All right.
for some is a little bit late. Some people like to get there a day early and leave a day late. It's a lot of partying in Vegas. I won't be doing the parties myself, but a lot of folks enjoy that.
It's summer camp. There could be, I don't know, s'mores or something. But let's talk, first of all, what is exactly Hacker Summer Camp? What's going on?
Sure. For those watching who aren't in the security community, next week are the three largest information security conferences, DEF CON, Black Hat, and B-Sides Las Vegas. And together they are a week of hacker and information security madness in a good way.
In a good way. And they'll be really packing them in Vegas, right? I think you mentioned, 42,000 people attendees?
I don't have a precise number to give you, but we're talking between 30 and 50,000 people. I would need to give you a precise figure, but there's a lot of people in Vegas during Hacker Summer Camp.
Great. So what do we really have to look out for? I mean, obviously at these conferences, there's just going to be a lot of talks. And I know that sort of a fixture of some of the conferences can be sort of these like hacking villages. So what are we really looking out for at these three conferences?
Sure. So each has their own character. DEF CON is the original hacker. It calls itself a hacker conference. And it's dedicated to all things hacker, the culture, breaking things. The old hacker model, proof of concept or get out, you know. And proving that something is broken has great value and has been very successful in drawing attention to things that are broken and in need of fixing. Because oftentimes software makers or device vendors don't wish to admit something is broken because it makes them look bad as from a marketing point of view. And that has been a very successful strategy for hackers and arguably society as a whole for decades. Black Hat is the next conference that emerged after DEF CON. Black Hat is the enterprise security conference, which dovetails a lot of CSO Online's be. We cover the enterprise security market for businesses who want to protect their customers' data, protect their own data. And then, of course, besides Las Vegas, which is the smallest of the three and perhaps the most policy-focused. And so what are we looking forward to this year? I'm seeing a transition from the let's prove things are broken to, well, okay, everything is broken. I mean, when was the last data breach story you read?
Yesterday, 2 days ago.
Right, and we're going to read another one tomorrow, right?
Yeah.
It's the most boring, you know. Oh, you have a data breach with only 10,000 people affected. That's not news anymore. Everything is broken. Everything is breached. You know, the old silly joke. There's two kinds of companies in the world. Those that know they've been breached and those that don't know. So we're in the situation where additional security research that proves things are broken in new and startling and horrible ways is a contribution to the community, to society. But now we're getting to a point where, like, now what? You know, is that making things better? Are we seeing stronger security controls and software projects from the enterprise? You know, Capital One was breached by a single lone disgruntled ex-employee of AWS just last week. Things are not getting better. I don't think anyone would realistically say things are improving.
Sure.
So the question, please.
Yeah, I think it is going to be sort of interesting to see what these solutions are. I mean, we do know that, I mean, as just an individual, as a consumer, as a customer, where, I mean, I can't even begin to imagine how many institutions have my data. I mean, Capital One is an obvious one because it's a bank. Obviously, my bank has my information, but there's only so much as an individual you can do to protect your data. You know, you cannot put your social security number on crazy websites, but you need that when you're applying for a credit card. So then you're putting your trust in other, in these big institutions' hands. And I think it would be interesting to see what some of these solutions and preventative measures are going to be. And I think that's interesting to see that sort of shift at the conferences from moving towards, let's break this voting machine or let's break into the server and get all 100 million people's data, to let's actually fix the problem.
Yeah, you know, I mean, there's still value, for instance, in hacking voting machines, demonstrating that the, that they are, in fact, vulnerable.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, as you say, the individual has very, very little control over their ability to defend themselves. It's the public health metaphor has become popular to discuss these kinds of issues. Like, maybe, you know, you have good sanitary practices and think you're going to avoid cholera, to give a yucky example, but if everybody around you practices poor sanitation, you remain vulnerable. So it becomes a public health crisis almost. How do we solve the problem at scale for the benefit of everybody? Mm-hmm. And that's the point where government and regulators and our elected representatives and, you know, leaders who need to be having this conversation need to step forward and make some hard decisions.
And I do know that in your article, you did a bit of a preview article about this, and we will link that below so our viewers can also check out that article if they're going to be attending one of these conferences, sort of JM's top talk picks. But I know that when you mentioned in some of these talks is that it really seems like there is sort of a focus on policymaking, which is very interesting. I think it would probably be encouraging to have some policy regulations to ensure that me as a consumer, my data and all of my information is still being protected, because there's these policies that companies have to follow in place.
Yes, I think the growing conversation we're seeing between technologists and policymakers is very encouraging. And hopefully not too little too late, because at the end of the day, tech and government have to work together for everyone's benefit, not just their own. And the more that people in those two spheres are often isolated from the other party, and the more we see the two encouraged to have a dialogue, I think the more progress we're going to see. And it won't happen in 1 year. It may not happen in 10 years. But I think we're slowly beginning to see this change take place. And it's a change that we should celebrate and encourage.
Absolutely. And I think it's also really interesting to see sort of how some of these chats and talks that are going on at these security conferences, which at first glance can seem very niche. I mean, I'm not a hacker, I'm not a CSO, but it's encouraging to see that there is some broader appeal for everyone. These talks that are happening are changes that really can help everyone, not just the CSO of Amazon.
Yeah, and the decisions the CSO of Amazon makes affect everybody. I mean, at this
Absolutely.
Point, even if you're not an Amazon customer, you probably have your data in an enterprise's database that's being stored on Amazon Web Services, right? Mm-hmm. So the future of Amazon affects all of us right now, for better or for worse.
And something, just before I let you go, something that you mentioned when we were just chatting about this before we started filming is that you really have seen sort of a positive trend at these sort of security conferences in Vegas. And do you think that's because of the new sort of shift towards preventative measures?
Policymakers are beginning to realize that if they want to, there are people in Congress who actually care. I won't talk about the rest, but there are good people in Congress who actually want to do the right thing, who actually want to make things better. And I've personally spoken to regulators who want to do the right thing, and finding ways to bring regulators and government officials and policymakers and elected representatives and hackers and security researchers and so forth all together in the same room to say, we have some problems, but we all are in the same boat together. This is all of us now. It's not mm-hmm. just you against me. This is all of us. And we are going to sink or swim together. And we need to work together for that end goal. And these kinds of conversations, I hope, will begin to move the needle on seeing positive changes for the future of our society.
Great. I think I'm really looking forward to seeing what sort of stuff you'll be writing while you're there. Can we look out for your articles during next week?
Absolutely. We will see what happens before I know what I'm going to write about.
That's true. I guess, you know, you can't predict it yet. Thanks so much,
right?
JM.
No, pleasure, Julia. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you so much for watching this episode of Tech Talk. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. We will have JM's preview article linked below, and we'll also be sure to link the TechFeed episode that I did about the Capital One breach, which we briefly mentioned here. Thank you so much for watching again, and we'll see you next time.